Marvel Studios has dropped a new Black Widow trailer. I think this trailer has actually made the perception of this new movie much worse. What I'm troubled by is this may be yet another demonstration of what we're seeing from movie studios where inconvenient canon is just somehow forgotten and erased. She's not a little bit dead. She's not like a parrot in a Monty Python sketch. She's way undead, dead, like forces of evil in the universe, dead. Per Marvel Studios' own press release, the action-packed spy thriller Black Widow sees Natasha Romanoff, aka Black Widow, confront the darker parts of her ledger when a dangerous conspiracy with ties to her past arises, pursued by a force that will stop at nothing, meaning Taskmaster, to bring her down. Natasha must deal with her history as a spy and the broken relationships left in her wake long before she became an Avenger. Now, as mentioned, the big bad in the movie Black Widow is Taskmaster. In the comics, he had the ability of mimicking his opponent's fighting style. And much like the character of the Winter Soldier, he is a mercenary. His ability to mimic, not just fighting styles, but other heroes, has allowed him to impersonate and infiltrate organizations. So, if this movie had been made prior to Infinity War, this would be great. Let's get back to the trailer again.
The trailer was a minute and 30-something seconds. The first 30 seconds is essentially jump cuts from Avengers Endgame.
That leaves us with a very paltry 60 seconds to show or generate interest for the Black Widow standalone movie. Objectively, in my opinion, does it do that? Absolutely not. I honest to God, this actually looks worse. They've shifted the focus from Black Widow to Taskmaster, who is now, I would say, what you remember from this trailer. Not Natasha, not Scarlett Johansson, but Taskmaster. Now, say what you will about all of the other main characters within the Marvel Universe, whether it be Iron Man, Captain America, Thor, even Spider-Man. When they have a movie about them, it really makes you appreciate and want to see that character. There's a reason for the movie. It's to move the character down a line of progression to move the larger Marvel story on. Now, it really seems the only reason this Black Widow movie was made was to transition the role from Scarlett Johansson to this new actress. Now, if that is in fact the case, who cares? Really? Why did they need to make this movie then? Don't bring in someone that you've already established for 11 freaking years through Scarlett Johansson as the Black Widow, and bring someone in like Scarlet Pug or Pugue or whatever the hell she is in this sort of shoehorn movie where the character you're going to replace has been freaking dead for 3 years. Florence Pug, or is it Florence Pugue? Pug? I don't know, let's say Pug. There's lots of explosions. There's not a lot of, I would say, anything to get you to care one damn bit about this new Black Widow character played by Scarlet Pug or Pew or whatever the hell it is. It's, like I said, whatever perceptions I've held of this movie, it went down more where I, honest to God, have no desire to even watch it on streaming. This is not exactly, I would say, a good look, as they say, for Marvel Studios, nor was WandaVision, which in no way excited me and I cared nothing about. Add that on to Falcon and Winter Soldier, which I don't care about at all after watching a couple of minutes being already, I would say, poison-pilled by those idiotic trailers. This is Phase 4, folks. This is where Marvel Studios is going. Do I have this wrong? Do you think I'm being overly critical? Are you excited after seeing the trailer? And I will include the link so that you can actually watch it in the comments section on YouTube. Does this do anything at all for you? I just think this looks pointless. It's pointless. I am Corey B. And this is Salty Salish C.